series.
Tune called Not Today. Your fan game from Japan. And I was off the plan. One hand clapping from July CE of the month. The Super Bowl and that we're going to be with Lamb in this half hour of Echoes Day. And if you missed that interview, you can catch it in Echoes Podcast. Just get back a couple of weeks. Really great interview with this band. If you want to get a playlist for today's Echoes, head over to our website at echoes.org. Our playlists have links to the albums and tunes. It's at echoes.org. I'm John DiLiberto. Thank you so much for being with me in this hour of Echoes today. Jeff Towns, the producer of the show, powerful fun, means made possible by the Black Family Foundation and the Pennsylvania Council on Arts. Additional funding comes from WXPN, Philadelphia, and Public Radio International Post Station. It's summer, but that music by Frostway. Ice and Bone. We're also going to hear from Swiss electronic musician Jonathan E. Blake with a new album called Fellowship of Jupiter. It's coming up this hour on Echoes on PRI Public Radio International.
This is WFUK Kalamazoo, streaming at WMUK.org. And available as a secondary audio channel on HD radio tuners.
From NPR News in Washington, I'm Jack Speer. Retired Supreme Court Justice John Paul Stevens has died. That's according to a statement from the High Court today. NPR's Nina Totenberg reports Stevens was known as a judge's judge.
His appointment to the court in 1975 was, as one of his law clerks observed, something of a historical accident. A brand new president, Gerald Ford, suddenly had a Supreme Court vacancy to fill. With the country still reeling from the Watergate scandal, the name of the game was to pick someone of unassailable credentials and no political connections. Stevens fit the bill. He went on to be an enormously influential justice, writing landmark decisions on presidential power, national security, and countless other subjects, from property rights to immigration, from abortion to school prayer, from campaign finance reform to the relationship between the federal and state governments.
Justice Stevens was 99 years old. He died in Florida of complications from a recent stroke. A Trump administration plan that would end most asylum protections for immigrants has left people anxious at the U.S.-Mexico border. plan announced Monday would reverse decades of U.S. policy in what is the administration's most forceful attempt to slash the number of people seeking asylum in the U.S. It covered large numbers of refugees, including those fleeing violence and poverty in Central America. The rule would require refugees to first seek safe haven in the third country in which they traveled to reach the U.S. House lawmakers voted mostly along party lines today to approve a resolution condemning President Trump's Twitter messages attacking four Democratic congresswomen. Congresswomen to return to the countries they came from, they didn't like the U.S. Late more than an hour over objection to Speaker Nancy Pelosi's comments on the floor criticizing Trump's tweets.
Every single member of this institution, Democratic and Republican, join us in condemning the president's racist tweets.
Republicans called for Pelosi's remarks to be stricken from the record. Representative Kevin McCarthy of California, the House GOP leader, among those who opposed the resolution.
Our rules of order and decency were broken today. And worse, the House just voted to condone the violation of the court.
Four Republicans voted with Democrats and one independent measure, which is non-binding. The nation's retailers had something to smile about last month, with sales rising at a relatively robust rate at a time other drivers of the economy appear to have weakened. As part of reporting today, retail sales in June rose at a solid 0.4% annual rate. Sales were up at retailers, grocery stores, home and garden stores, restaurants, and bars. Stocks lost ground on Wall Street today. The Dow was down 23 points to 27,335. The NASDAQ closed down 35 points today. This is... Christine Lagarde has announced she is resigning as head of the International Monetary Fund, calling her nomination to be the next head of the European Central Bank. Lagarde has already given up day-to-day duties, suspending director of the IMF with an acting director in place. She says her official resignation will take place in September. In Chicago, embattled R&B singer R. Kelly pleaded not guilty to 13 federal charges today. The indictment alleges child pornography and obstruction of justice.
Federal prosecutors in the Northern District of Illinois say that Kelly made substantial hush money payments to silence alleged victims, five girls, and members of their families. This indictment was one of two federal cases against the singer unsealed last week. The other was in New York and includes charges of racketeering and sexual trafficking involving five alleged victims, including three girls. Altogether, the alleged incidents span two decades, from 1998 to 2018. The 18 federal charges include child pornography, kidnapping, obstruction of justice, and trafficking minors and women for sexual purposes. The federal judge has ordered Kelly to remain in custody while he awaits trial. Anastasia Tsoukas, NPR News, New York.
An alligator that eluded Chicago authorities for a week finally met its match in an expert from Florida who captured it using a fishing pole in a public lagoon. It was up Chance the Snapper, was pulled from a plastic tub by the man who caught it, a 5-foot-3-inch-long reptile. Didn't do much snapping, though, since his mouth was taped shut. So it would be taken to a zoo or wildlife sanctuary. I'm Jack Spear, NPR News.
Support for NPR comes from Americans for the Arts, committed to transforming America's communities through the arts and arts education. Mm. Supporting the nonprofit arts industry, which employs 4.6 million people nationwide. Learn more at AmericansfortheArts.org.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.